Okay, first of all, just very proud of our team. You know, our first SEC home game against a good Mississippi State club. You know, our defense, you know, played great again. I believe we had two interceptions. I think we had four fourth down stops. They answered the bell time and time again. Offensively, thought we played well offensively. We hit some shots, and the last two games when we hit shots, we scored points, and I thought that was a big factor. Our quarterback was very efficient. Again, you know, I thought that was really something. You know, just overall, we got off to a good start. And we got off to a good start. Our crowd was unbelievable. I think we had seven false starts. And I've said this before, I think this is the best home field advantage there is in college football because of our fans. And they were loud. It was extremely loud. They were a big part of our success tonight. But I'm proud of our team. It's a good step in the right direction. Questions?
Statistically, that was one of the best efficiency performances by a quarterback since Cam. For him to complete 14 shots against the number 9 pass defense in the country, yeah. What does it say about Jarrett's development? Already?
Well, I think you see him every week getting more and more comfortable. You know, we're protecting him, you know, well. And the guys are making plays. Our receivers are growing up, and they're making plays down the field. And I think that it's just kind of all starting to come together. And then, you know, starting to get more comfortable with Chip, and Chip's getting more comfortable with him. And, you know, 2 weeks in a row or 3 weeks in a row, just been very efficient. But against that group, you know, that was very impressive.
Can you speak to the play from the 1 yard line, that 57 yard pass, just what went into the.
Yeah, that's about the 1 foot line. It was really close right there, you know, and that's just what Chip decided to do. You know, that was part of his game plan, that get the ball on the left hash on the 1 yard line. That's the play he's going to call, and they executed it. And, you know, that was a big factor in the game, too. I think that was a 99 yard drive, and right there is the first, I believe it was the first drive the offense got the ball in the third quarter. And after that drive that they scored a touchdown on, you know, everything was a little bit easier. Take a deep breath right there. But that was a big-time throw, big-time catch, good protection, and a big-time call.
Gus, can you talk about first down success offensively and then defensively containing Nick Fitzgerald?
You know, Nick Fitzgerald, he's like a running back there. He scares you to death. And he throws the ball well, too. And you've got to stop him first in the run game, because if he starts getting going, the play action's scary. And I thought our defense did a very good job containing him, keeping him from those big runs that he scares you to death with. And we were physical up front, you know, and I think we were physical in front on both sides.
And then first downs
offensively. Yeah, first downs. Yeah, and y'all seen this before. You know, when we get that first down, we get in rhythm, and that's usually when we're at our best.
Can you talk about the secondary and their play today, holding them 13-33?
Our secondary was unbelievable. They were all over them. And, you know, our secondary's played well all season. You know, very good, clamping people down in man coverage, making them earn it. And they got some receivers that are pretty good, too. So I thought our secondary had a very good night.
Coach, you talked about Will Hastings before, had another stellar performance tonight. What does that do for you as a coach in the offense to know you have another guy you can lean on to go get more?
Yeah, you know, Will is a guy that, you know, showed flashes last year. And then, of course, in the spring, he really took the next step forward. And, you know, he's a dynamic route runner. When he gets space on people, he's really tough to handle. And he scored on the double move and did a super job, you know, on that play.
Gus, it doesn't seem like a lot of people have figured out how to block Jeff Holland yet this year.
You know, he's really raised his level. He's taken his game to the next level. He did that in the spring, and it's carried over here in games, and he's a weapon. I think he caused a couple of those false starts, too, along with the noise just when he widened out. And, you know, he's such a good edge speed rusher, and he's playing the run well, too. He's just really raising his game.
I just want to throw a stat out at you. You're the only team in the FBS that hasn't allowed more than 14 points all season. When you your wildest dreams have expected that?
You know, we had a good defense last year, and we had a lot of guys coming back, and you could tell in the spring it was different. They have a different attitude. They know Coach Steele's defense inside and out. They're playing extremely hard. They're playing with that edge. But, no, I wasn't aware of that. That's a great stat. And, you know, hopefully we can keep building upon that.
Obviously a new wrinkle with the Wildcat there, foot to Jared for that deep pass.
Yeah.
What went into that?
You know, it's a play that we've had up you know, since fall camp, and I think we were 100% run out of the Wildcat, and so Chip was, you know, wanting to wait to a third and short to try to get a zero look, you know, where they were playing the run and thought we had a chance, and, you know, he's repped that probably 20 or 30 times, and then it was wide open. That was a big play in the game.
Gus, did you think it was important to have back-to-back good offensive games, not only for the players but for Chip?
You know, I think so. I mean, you know, you can see, you know, the progression. You know, you can see Jarrett getting more comfortable. You can see, you know, the balance. I think we were pretty balanced tonight. You know, as far as 244 rushing yards and 267, the balance, we talked about that, and that's what Chip brings us. And, you know, we hit some vertical shots.
Can you talk about the change in the offensive line?
Yeah, we it just felt like put some more experience up there. And, you know, Tega played some tight end. You know, Tega's going to be an outstanding player, but we just felt like we put a little bit more experience up there. And so that was kind of the thinking, but we got a lot of confidence in Tega.
For Carry On, for me, the running game.
Yeah.
It's his first time in his career, say, back-to-back multi-touchdown games. How do you feel about his performance? And also, that way, did you want to try to get him more?
Well, you know, first of all, Carry On, I mean, you know, he's playing with a band on his leg. And you could see him when he broke that one, you know, he wasn't going to pull it again. And the fact that he's not 100% says a lot about him. And, you know, he was pretty hot, and we put Petway in there. And, you know, he's not quite 100% either, you know, as far as that goes. But I was proud of KJ and the job he did, you know, especially in the goal line. There was a couple of tough runs that he found a way and willed himself, you know, to get in the end zone.
You guys realize that obviously with them not 100%, they're slowing down a little bit. Is that why you made those adjustments like at halftime? You guys were running the ball outside. Is that kind of the plan if they were down to do some different things?
You talking about?
Yeah, Eli
Stowe. Oh, yeah, to get them on the perimeter. Yeah, you know, they were stuffing everything pretty good and just talked at halftime about getting the ball on the perimeter. Eli had the big one right there that really opened things up. And the thing about the perimeter runs, you know, if you get one big one, it usually kind of loosens things up. And that was just kind of the talk at halftime, that try to get the ball on the edge a little bit. And there were some real good blocks at the point of attack, and Eli almost took it to the house.
I think that's 2 weeks in a row now that Dale Thomas has come up with a stop on pick.
Yeah, you know, that's a pretty interesting deal. It's the same really fake punt that we stopped last week. And, you know, Coach Horton did a super job. That exact fake, he probably repped it three or four times, and the way it fit and all that. And so that was a big play in the game. I don't think we were able to score points. You know, that was, I think, that's when we missed the field goal right there. But that was a big stop. And, you know, Coach Horton did a super job of kind of predicting, you know, what they would be thinking. And sure enough, they did it.
You started a little slow last year and then got on a roll, and it felt like you were really hot to the injury. You see any similar just how this is?
But, you know, 2 weeks in a row, we played really good football, you know, really in all three phases. You know, I'd like to think we're getting some momentum, and we still made some mistakes. We can get better on third downs and things like that. But, you know, if we keep improving just a little bit each week, we got a chance to be a good football team.
Well, how did the decision to go with Dane Marshall? How do you feel that?
You know, he has been practicing very well. And the last 2 weeks, he probably won the competition, you know, at practice. And so we just felt strong, give him an opportunity. I thought he played well. I thought he had some good kicks. He, the moment wasn't too big. A lot of times, you know, you worry about that. But he did a good job. And, you know, I was impressed.
Thank you, Warren.
Yeah, you know, Trey, a little banged up. Obviously, we kept him out last week. He could have played tonight in an emergency situation. Obviously, it was fortunate we were able to rest him another week, you know, as far as that goes. And Cam Martin was a little bit banged up, too, you know, from the last game. So, we were able to hold him out. You know, Malik Miller, I thought, ran really hard, you know, when he was in the fourth quarter. So, you know.
How important was it to have Javaris Davis back for dying personal where he has that big six, but because he held Fitzgerald 2 for 13 on third down with both his picks.
So yeah. Yeah, I mean, Javaris is he's an impact player for us. You know, we held him out last week. He played extremely well, obviously had the impact play on the pick six. And, you know, he's one of our top defensive backs, and when he's on the field, you know, it really helps.
Right. Last one. moving forward, do you see Malik Willis, he had a 67-yard touchdown run, do you see Malik Willis being that filling for a backup quarterback to move forward offense?
You know, I mean, Malik's one play away from playing. You know, so he's got to prepare like he's a starter. And, you know, that play he made, I mean, that kind of looked like Nick Marshall-ish, you know, as far as, you know, just kept it and nobody knew he had the ball until he breaks free. He's got a unique ability. You know, Chip has a plan for him, you know, and we'll just see where that goes. But he's one play away from being our starting quarterback. So.
All right, good. Okay. Thank you.